John Dare joined the RNLI as a 26-year-old in 1959. Back then, the boats were larger and slower, and 18 call-outs a year was considered a record. Today, it's almost a full-time occupation, and the technology is there to match. The one thing that never changes is the courage and commitment needed by any lifeboatman, and John's courage has been well documented. In 1985, he was commended for his part in the rescue of the crew of a French fishing vessel off Loo. And in 1974, he received the RNLI Bronze Medal after the search for crewmen missing from the Merck Enterprise during a fierce storm off the south coast.
Well, they sent the helicopter out to look for us because they were getting worried. They called us back three times because the weather was worsening. But the thing was that we was already out there, and it was more dangerous to come back in front of a sea than going straight at it. So we were safe enough, actually.
Despite an extensive air and sea sweep, there were only seven survivors. Seven men were never found, leading to the hardest decision any rescue service can take, to call off a search.
You always got it in the back of your mind that it could be somebody there, and they may be just hanging on for the last minute, you know, for somebody to come up. And it's very, very difficult, but then there is a time when you've got to say, well, it's hopeless, we can't. When it's that dark and you use all your parachute flares up and the searchlights are, and all you're picking up is big seas, you've got a job to pick up people in the water.
Almost all the rescues he's carried out are recorded in a scrapbook, a lifetime of memories John will find hard to relinquish.
I'll miss it, I'm bound to. I'm just dreading the day when the boat's called out and I'll be left on the side. But it's got to come, and this is it, you know. But I will miss it a lot.
For one final memory, his crew arranged for John to be picked up from the deck of his own lifeboat for a final flight over his old domain.
I was all dressed up and they said, got an helicopter for you. I said, no, I'm not going in the water. But no, they said there's no water. But when the helicopter lifted me up and he went around Mount Edgecombe, I thought they were going to drop me in the field, you know, and I'm going to find my own way back. I thought somebody's going to pull a fast one on me. So.
And you say you're going to miss that comradeship.
That's right, yeah. Well, it's all in good fun, you know, we enjoy ourselves. And it's surprising how you get called out on a real bad night and everybody's tense, and all of a sudden somebody will come out with a joke and it breaks the atmosphere, and everybody's eased down a bit, you know.
But for compulsory retirement, John says he would happily have stayed at sea with the RNLI for the rest of his